was your name? Oh, who do I see? Who is it? What are you eating?
Huh?
Where you going?
Yeah. Hey,
where you going? Where you going?
Where you going? My aunt gave them to me. She's got another pair just like them for me.
Oh, does she?
Where are you going?
Because I need a pair of running shoes. I have no running shoes.
I was with the team to make it from one district to another.
Cookie.
Better get you a good sport bra.
Cookie.
And if you don't, your boobs will hurt.
What is that, big gluten?
You'll lay down that night and go. She said she's pregnant, won't she? She'll think her nipples are going to blow up.
Justin was here.
Mama!
He's gonna get caught now.
And then got everybody.
Then let me get my gun. Be kind to you.
Hey, there's my shoe.
Alright, just go there with them. Miles. It's a camcorder. We're going to watch it on TV.
I do like this when we start wagging
the leg. Look at Ian.
I remember that little
all that shit. Let me get a picture of y'all two together.
Look, I got monkeys.
You guys see how they act.
Monkeys. Y'all silly.
Watch out, Billy's behind you.
Look, I'm taping monkeys. Two little monkeys. Billy and Justin hitting themselves.
Ew.
That's grandma. Y'all want to give it to grandma and give her a hug and stuff? Real easy? Give her an easy one. Oh, that's a good hug. All right, give them a hug.
Doing the pink.
Yeah. We'll watch it on TV later. Look, there's grandma. Wave, grandma. How old are you going to be?
94.
Yeah.
Can I hold it?
Good.
I want to hold that.
What is the, let's see, watch out, Eddie.
Sorry.
What is the most horrific event you ever lived through?
The Great Depression.
Yeah, the Great Depression.
The Great Depression.
When was that? 30, 32?
She was 15 years old when the Titanic
sank. She wasn't born when the Titanic sank.
I know
what
I was thinking of her. I could do that. I
don't
know.
There's an
answer.
I want to have it.
Maybe.
All right, well, I got another. I got the million-dollar question. Everybody wants to know, but was too scared to ask.
Vanessa!
You want me to say it?
Vanessa.
All right, everybody wants to know if Granddaddy was the only man for you.
There you go.
There's the million-dollar question, y'all. It's answered.
That ain't what I heard.
Get right there by
Mama's knee.
Okay. I'm going home.
Okay.
He says, if you put me off that long, I think I'll take you home.
Well, that's the question everybody wants to know all the time.
I don't know, Grandma.
They just told the truth. So whoever said it wasn't telling the truth, brother. They weren't telling the truth, whoever said it. If they heard different.
Well, that's exactly wrong.
Yeah. Let's see. What else do we want to know? What was the one worst thing that ever happened to you?
When my two babies died.
When your two babies died.
Three weeks apart.
Get right face to face. When we do our interviews, we do interviews. There you go. Well, I'm running out of questions. Let's
ask
see.
Where she was born, where she was born.
I already know all that, but I'll ask her. Go ahead, Grandma.
Back when I got married, they didn't sell sex for 25 cents. They were virgins until they got married.
That's right.
As a mother. Okay, I'm listening.
Let's see. I know all these questions right here, but I'm going to ask them anyway, okay?
Right.
Where were you born? Lexington County?
Lexington County.
And let's see, your mama's name?
Daisy Rogers. Snowbird.
And your daddy's name?
Simon Peter Snowbird.
And, can you name all your brothers and sisters?
I couldn't get her name.
Okay.
Carl Melbourne. Child.
Yeah?
Wilfred Melbourne. Died at 13. Next was Harvey Melbourne. Next was Scotty Melbourne. Next was Bell Melbourne. Next was J.D. Melbourne. Next was Wilbur Melbourne.
So really, you had two sisters and one died at 13?
No, just one sister.
But, yeah, so you had two. Aunt Pearl and Bertha died. Is that right? Did I ask that? I might have said it wrong.
Pearl was the only woman. She was 85.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Yeah, okay.
So you had two sisters and all the rest were brothers. And where did you get married at?
Stuart Park.
That's right. And how old was Granddaddy Neville when he died?
How old was
she when she
had
sex?
47.
And then came Daddy, then Uncle Pat, and then Uncle Wayne. And who'd you name Daddy for? Jean Paul.
A movie.
Do you remember what movie? And how about Uncle Wayne?
Well, he was named John Wayne and Carl White.
Who was Carl White?
A singer, country singer.
Oh, okay. How about Uncle Pat?
He was named after
Man, I just had to see a car wreck.
Movie star.
I just thought
actually, movie star.
And he was named Neville after his daddy, right? Neville Patrick?
Well, not exactly. Pat was Neville's Patrick.
That's right.
Patton was Army General, and I didn't
want a
junior.
That's right.
So I changed it from Patton to Patrick.
I like Patrick. I wonder what it would have been like if he had been here, your husband, our granddaddy.
He had a Joe Lincoln on the
table.
You can tell, boy, he's in there.
Did you ever think that you'd live to see this many great-grandchildren?
Never.
Do you know how many great-grandchildren you have?
Only at Christmas time.
Only at Christmas time.
Hey, what did she say?
I asked her if she knew how many great-grandchildren she had. Yeah, only at Christmas time. Somebody figure it out.
I see, there's yours, there's mine. One, two, three, four, five. Just out of me and you.
All right, okay, that's five. Dylan is six. Vanessa's seven.
He's all right.
Terry's got two. Eight, nine. Wayne's got two. 10, 11.
He's all right, girl. He just looks scared.
13. Vanessa's got one.
Terry's okay.
Vanessa got two. 14.
Terry's got three.
Well, okay, Eddie's
got three. 14, 15, 16, 17.
Uh-huh. You shortchanging somebody, Grandma.
Well,
the last
count.
No.
I don't know how many Brian's got.
I've
never seen any of them.
How many does Brian have?
Two.
Two,
I think.
Brian.
Yeah.
Two.
Two.
Eight, that's 19.
That's 19.
All right, that should be it then.
I think that's it.
Huh? I don't know, baby.
But I'm sure there's plenty more to come somewhere.
Yeah. They said the pills don't work anymore, so it'll be home.
They say that what don't work anymore?
Pills.
Oh, they must not know where they give it away at.
25 cents.
Yeah, there you go.
You know that old saying, two bit.
That's right. Let's see. Anybody else got a question?
They're making a video of Grandma Anna.
I do, but I don't.
How much money you gonna leave her?
Bella wants to know if you're gonna leave her any money.
They tell me it takes it all to bury
her. That's no. Look, if over the years we haven't all gotten enough, we've all gotten enough. Who is that creeping up over here?
That's my boy.
Is that Dylan?
That's Dylan. He's getting away.
So the Great Depression was probably the worst time. What made it so bad?
Well,
other than beans.
You couldn't find a job.
Is that how y'all wound up in Georgia?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Scotty's husband said that he
did. Whose husband?
Scotty's in-law.
Oh, okay. Scotty's wife, her in-law. Okay. The robber.
Yeah. No, the
Reddick.
Yeah.
That's right.
Said that it was easy to get farm.
It don't matter if I did.
They would place you on the farm and give you. Things to farm with, as a loan, which you never would ever pay back. So we went up there. They didn't own all that easy money.
Well, when y'all were up in Fort Valley, when the babies got sick, was that picking peaches?
Yeah. That's what we went there for.
And I know at one time y'all lived in Eatonton, Georgia, over in Putnam County, in some meal houses.
Yeah. I don't remember what we were doing.
Looking for work?
I guess so,
Because that's where Uncle J.D. met Aunt Katie, is that right?
Yeah.
And Uncle Scotty met his wife, but I can't think of her first name. Reddick?
Molly
Reddick, that's right.
Yeah. He was doing road work, and he was.
I know the Roberts and the Reddick, they were related, and they were from Putnam County.
Yeah.
And when you pass away, are you going to be buried in Fort Valley?
Yes.
With your baby?
Yes.
And where's Granddaddy? He's buried in Florida? Is that Dania?
Dania.
That's near Hollywood, isn't it?
Well, yeah.
Anything you want to contribute to this
interview? I'd like to know the cold cat that said I was a 25-cent two-bit whore when I married my husband. I'd give him a mouthful.
All right, I'll try to locate that.
Can't help
me. Okay. Y'all back, and we got that cold cat straight. And we got the truth settled, and it's all resolved for all time. We weren't happy about that.
Careful.
doing, buddy?
Are you a Republican or a Democrat?
Oh, I'm a Republican.
Okay, so who was the very first president you ever voted for?
Well, back in the Depression days, I was a Democrat. And Roosevelt was my hero. He got us out of that Depression. He took 10 cents off of every millionaire and put us back in working. And then, I started working with a group of people. And he got this Republican president. I can't remember what his name was. But I changed over from a Democrat to a Republican. It seemed to me like all the money people were Republicans. So I was happy to stay Republican.
Did you vote for John Kennedy?
Yeah, he was a good president.
But he was a good president, though, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was a good president.
Who was the last president you voted for? The last time you went to the polls?
I can't remember.
All right, let's go back a little way. Did you vote for Carter?
I think I did, but he was a Democrat.
Yeah, I think so. He was. And what about Reagan?
Oh, yeah. All right. Movie hero.
What about George Bush?
Yeah, I like George Bush.
Did you vote for him?
Yeah, and I voted for him
then. All right, so you voted on up here to the last president. So you've been current on your voting.
Okay.
You've been current on voting?
I didn't have nobody take me last year. But the year before, or the 2 years before.
Okay. I think to ask a question.
I believe in that vote.
Who do you think thus far has been the best president?
Reagan.
Any reason why? Any reason why?
Well, you didn't see all these buildings closed up now to this. Everything was buzzing.
What did you think about when September the 11th, 2001?
Once we catch the rat. We have all them boys God trying to find him. And when they get him, he only gets what he gives all boys.
That was a scary time, wasn't it?
Yeah, I know.
But you've lived through a lot more than that. You saw what happened through World War II. When Japan bombed Pearl Harbor. Do you remember where you were at when that happened?
Yeah.
Where were you at?
I was in Miami with my husband. I was pregnant with Pat. He was born February the 6th. And this man had given us a German Shepherd. And he was sitting out in the yard. And I had the radio on. And it started screaming and screaming. And I said, let me see what's going on. And I went back in and they said, Pearl Harbor has... The Japanese had just bombed Pearl Harbor. And this man, he was with ROTC. And he says, well, let me get to my post. I got to go. I'll see the dog another day. I can hardly wait never to get home to tell him about Pearl Harbor being bombed.
Let's go to religion for a quick minute here. Were you ever baptized? Where were you baptized?
Blackwood, St. Andrew's Lutheran Church.
In Blackwood?
In Blackwood.
That's right. And that's where you're a member currently, is that right? You're still a member of that church.
That's not the hungry one. The hungry one's walking around over there.
But you're still a member, though. It's always understood as you get older, your membership stays, but you may not be able to attend. It's understood.
What the hell?
But I have learned more about the Bible from the Jehovah's Witness people than never learned from when my money stopped, they stopped.
Yeah, and you have a friend that comes out to your house.
Every Saturday.
And what's her name?
I can't remember that lady.
How about your best friend? That just made me think of that.
She's my only friend.
Your Jehovah's Witness friend? What about Emmy?
I can't find her name.
You can't find her back after?
I can't find nobody back.
We're still looking for.
Cassie said they got it, but he needs it tomorrow. I said, never said he needs it back tomorrow. Cassie said,
oh, baby. See, I was gone for years. Where I was living, they told her that was a business phone that wasn't no social calls coming in.
Well, we know she's probably still around somewhere. If something had happened to her, we would.
She has passed away. And you see, I'm not home now. I'm not home.
Yeah, well, we'll find her and we'll give her this phone number. What about when John Kennedy was assassinated?
I was at work. So, manufacturing companies. And it started whispering from the office. Everybody left their sewing machine. What they say, and he had to let us out because nobody was.
What about when Elvis Presley died?
Same thing happened.
You were at work?
No, I wasn't at work.
You were at home?
I don't know what I'm saying.
I'll help your memory on this one right here. I remember. I was 9 years old, and I remember they announced it over the radio, and you and my mama were sitting outside at the front of your house, and y'all started crying and boo-hooing, had the radio on, and y'all were just crying. And we were all walking around on pins and needles, because we're like, all right, Grandma and Mama are crying. Something's going on. And we couldn't understand all that crying about Elvis Presley, but I understand it now. And somebody needs to get Dylan.
Huh?
Get Dylan. Let's support that thing. What's the further state you've ever been? How far west have you been? Well, I know you were in California, because I was with you one time, and I know you've been as far in Florida as you can go.
Yeah.
Have you ever visited a foreign country?
No.
What was the first car you ever saw?
My daddy bought a Chalmers 7-passenger to move us to Florida.
What year was that? Do you remember?
1924.
And that was the same. That was 1924, and that was the model of the car.
I don't know. It wasn't an old one.
What was the first car you ever owned?
In my name?
Either way.
Just before he died, I was running the boarding house.
What color was it?
Black.
There's a picture you gave me a long time ago. I'll have to get it out for you, but I know Daddy's in it, and there's some other little kids down in St. Augustine. And they're sitting beside the old fort in St. Augustine.
Yeah.
Do you remember that picture?
Yeah.
And there's some kids sitting there. Whose kids would those would have been? Your brother-in-law, Aunt Pearl? Okay, who was that? I'm confused.
Lee Henderson.
Oh, and I asked him, I said, by the way, I said, just out of curiosity.
He has three daughters.
Jackson Lee? Jackson Lee Henderson?
Yeah.
And he had three daughters?
Yeah.
And those were probably his three?
Nudie!
That would have been his three?
He didn't offer to be his three, yeah.
I'm talking about he didn't offer to be his three.
we had gone to
don't mess with her.
Her sister married my brother. So we went to see her. She went to another.
That's right.
Careful.
You got $100.
Do you know where Jackson Lee is buried?
St. Peter's Church.
Okay. We need to reduce it by 40%. I said, so that means it's going from $100 to $60. And I said, then you drop it off.
And your daddy helped you to build your home out in Blythewood. Is there any greater place than home?
Never.
Has there ever been a place you ever loved more than Blythewood?
He said, well, then say that was the going rate. I said, $10 a square foot.
I don't live there as long as it is one.